action is expected to be. Eric, people there are now preparing for a direct hit, and this has shifted. We thought it was going to hit right on Miami, and now it's over where you are now. I would hope it's a ghost town out there.
For the most part, yes, Matt. I just talked to a.
This is right outside my window. These guys are doing a live.
Right behind me is the Manatee River. And back to those people that were walking by here, so they said that they didn't expect that they were going to have to go to a shelter. They are headed to a shelter now. All the shelters around Manatee County, Sarasota County, they're all open right now because we are expected to take a direct hit. When we were coming from Miami, we got here about an hour and a half ago or so. We spent most of the day driving up from Miami. We saw a lot of people starting to come back to Miami because this track has now moved a little bit west. That's not to say Miami isn't going to get very strong hurricane force winds, because again, this thing is huge, as we've been telling you, as Tom has been drilling into you. It is monstrous. It's one of the biggest storm at this point that we have ever seen. So still though, people are feeling in Miami that now they're a little bit safer because this track has shifted. So people were actually coming back down the turnpike as we were headed here. So again, downtown Bradenton, here Manatee County specifically, and Sarasota County, this is where the eye is supposed to pass over directly if this track verifies. So the idea is it would come from the west, like I said, it would come up the coast of Florida, and it would blow right over us. We're talking Cat 3, 100-some mile-an-hour winds, well above 100-mile-an-hour winds. A lot of the folks who live here are worried about their boats, they're worried about the downtown, they're worried about flooding. Storm surge here is supposed to be in this spot, and this was the last number I heard. I think it's gone up, but they're saying here alone would be 3 to 5 feet. Again, the governor was talking about bigger numbers than that. But the latest I heard, so it's 5 feet, like I said last night in Miami, it's 5 feet above ground level, not 5 feet above the water level. So here's our live truck over there. Well, I mean, you know, that's a 10-foot truck.
Hey, there's my house.
That would be, and this is a place where most people come. This guy, you've seen him going back and forth out on the docks. We saw another gentleman who was clearing everything out of the boat. A whole bunch of boats, because this river, the Manatee River, goes out to the intercoastal. This is actually the intercoastal also, but this actually goes out to the Gulf too. So these boats, the guy was telling me he feels a little bit better about, because you see this big, thick seawall that goes all the way around here, all the way around the harbor. Across, Jeff, I know it's kind of hard to see, but across the Manatee River, there's another marina there, and there are a whole lot of sailboats there, especially you can see those tall masts. I don't know if you can tell from the shot, I know it's getting dark, but there is no seawall over there.
That's not true.
Thing about those docks, is they're fixed. They don't rise. So look at these docks. You see these pilings here? You see the pier goes out, and there are surrounding that.
These are floating docks.
That this dock system goes up and down with the tide, but also when we have some storm surge. So the guy was saying with this boat here, if it's protected by the seawall, it can rise if we have storm surge. Question is, how much wind are we going to get? That's the other big concern down here. So if we get these 100-plus-mile-an-hour winds here, all of these boats, I mean, you know, you've seen pictures of what that kind of hurricane-force winds, we've seen pictures from the island, does to all of these boats. Again, all of those boats there. And then the water, once it comes up from the Manatee River again, because this is connected to the Gulf, could go into the street and flood downtown Bradenton. There are some spots here. In fact, I used to live up the street here. We're on State Road 64 in Bradenton. And there are some spots here that are flood-prone. I mean, this is fairly low-lying. We don't have a whole lot of room here. This is maybe, I don't know if we're at high tide or low tide. I guess we're kind of low tide here. So we got about 4, maybe 5 feet or so until the water would be at the top here. But again, storm surge, you got to remember, it's not from the top of the water, it's from the top of the street. So issues here, like we said, very strong winds. People around here tell me that they have not seen hurricanes here like this one, like Irma, really ever. When I lived here was early 2000 to 2001. We had one storm that was more drill than anything. I was out on the beach in Sarasota County for that. The storm surge brought the ocean level up a little bit. We had a little bit of flooding, but really nothing major. The gentleman who I was telling you about, who was walking back and forth here, he was saying that he grew up here and he remembers nothing like this, at least in this area. For the most part, the Tampa Bay area, Sarasota, Manatee County, the woman who called and talked to Tom a few minutes ago, she's got family in Northport, that's south Sarasota County, that's just south of Venice. This area has been fairly lucky when it comes to big storms. We haven't had anything major. So people are concerned. They're very nervous. The guy with the sailboat told me, Matt Lisa, he said, I don't know what to expect. He kept saying it over and over again. He said, I just don't know what this place is going to look like.
120 mile an hour winds, he can expect some bumper boats out there.
Yeah, it could devastate that area. And as it's getting dark there, people trying to prepare as much as they can. We'll be right back.
It's not really low tide until a couple more hours. So that wind, as you can see, it's out of the east. It's pushing the water out of the river, which also means in 6 hours when it comes back in, the wind will be stronger. I'll try to get some video of them. Okay, this is a looks like a little break in the cloud cover right now. It's about 10:50, so that is absolute low tide. It won't get any lower than that. You can see how far out the water is. So next, the tide will start coming back in, and if the wind shifts around to the northwest, that might be a bad thing. Right now, it's out east, northeast, mostly east. Like the wind is still pushing the water out of the river. It's even lower than that's the lowest I've ever seen. Comes in, it could be trouble. Okay, so what you're seeing now, I put the door down, or I put the shutter down, because I noticed there was water in the track, and what's actually happening is the wind is blowing under the door. Lowering the water, bubbling the water. So I'm going to see if I can I'll put a big towel in there to stop that from happening. Sails in this marina here, shredded. People that didn't take their roller furling head sails down, they didn't secure them. There's one here and there's two way down there by the Green Bridge. Not very smart. Everybody knows you take your sails off. I had a little trouble getting the sliding door open this morning. It pushed it off the track. Carpeting inside is wet. Storm surge never happened. It's pretty high right now because the wind's coming from the other direction. Apparently the curfew's over because I see people. Sunny.